You wake up, start the day, and power up your Galaxy Book 4 Ultra, but as soon as you put on two windows, you notice fans already kicking in loudly, and the experience on desktop and while browsing the internet is sluggish. You are then wondering what's going on, and if you happen to have hardware in full 64, you check out and find this. A view full of red indicators, core and package thermal throttling, temperature exceeding 100 degrees, and power consumption at over 71 watt at even the simplest desktop task. So what went wrong? It turns out that Intel Meteor Lake chip used in the Galaxy Book 4 Ultra is too demanding for such a thin and compact laptop. It has 16 cores and it's impossible to use it to its full potential because it's overheating even during simple tasks, leading to inconsistent performance. Today I'll show you a way to stop it from that, allowing it to run much cooler, saving power, and improving performance consistency while keeping turbo performance on set once and for all. So let's get started. First of all, open the Start menu, search for Registry Editor, right-click, and run it as Administrator. Now, paste in the navigation box above the directory URL provided in the pinned comment of this video, which will take you to some power settings configurations. We'll see there is this parameter called Attributes, by default set to a value of 1. Let me show you what this does. When you go to the Windows Power Plan settings, click on Plan Settings, then Advanced Power Settings. Under Processor Power Management, you will only see minimum and maximum processor power state, but if you go back to the Registry Editor and change the attribute value from 1 to 2 and then press OK, when we return to the Advanced Power Settings, we now see a new option under Processor Power Management called Processor Performance Boost Mode. By default, it's set to aggressive for both battery and plugged-in states, meaning the CPU can boost to a higher frequencies, going from base clock 2.3 up to 5.1 GHz on P cores and from 1.8 up to 3.8 GHz on the E cores. Now there are multiple options here: efficient, aggressive, at granted, aggressive at granted, efficient, aggressive, efficient, enabled, and enabled, and finally disabled. All options essentially maintain boosting except for disabled, which stops boosting entirely and limits the CPU to its base clock. You can set this for either battery, plugged in, or both states. So we'll set it to disabled for both of them, and that's it. Now let's look at some benchmarks to see the difference. Here we are in Cinebench R23 running a multi-core test, and let's see the results we've got. Here we have the first three columns with CPU boosting on, from quiet, optimized, and turbo mode that you can toggle on the Galaxy Book 4 Ultra. On the first column, we have the CPU boost off the week we just applied with turbo performance mode set. In terms of scores, the quiet setting scored the lowest. With CPU boost off, we got 10,370, which is a noticeable reduction from 15,742 scored with turbo mode and CPU boost on. But look at the max core voltage. With CPU boost off, it's at 0.7 volt compared to 1.3 with CPU boost on. Surely P and E core clocks are nearly halved, but the upside is clear. Our max temperature in this test is 69 degrees Celsius with CPU boost off, surpassing even quiet mode with CPU boost on, while our max power consumption is at 28 watt versus 35, 64, and a monstrous 70 watt in turbo mode with CPU boost on. So while we lose about one-third of the multi-core performance compared to CPU boost on in turbo, we've reduced temperature by 35 degrees and lowered down power by 42 watt. This makes a big difference, especially if you are bothered by fan noise, and also helps to maintain sustained performance as we'll see later on. Even when checking the chassis exterior temperature after this Cinebench R23 benchmark, here is what we can find. On default quiet, our midpoint is at 34.4 degrees with a hotspot at 49.5. Default with optimized mode shows a midpoint of 36.3 and a hotspot of 44.4. While turbo mode shows 39.4 at midpoint and hotspot of 46.5. Finally, with CPU boost off and turbo mode on, we have 34.7 degrees on midpoint and 41.7 degrees for the hotspot. With CPU boost off and turbo mode, our exterior temperature midpoint matches the quiet mode and even the hotspot is a little bit lower. This means you will feel less warmth coming out from the keyboard area during use. Now let's check the same setup in a gaming benchmark. Here we are playing Cyberpunk 2077 with default settings. Some of them are set on Ultra with DLSS and ray tracing enabled. We are running it as the original display max resolution in order to make it like a true user gaming scenario. On a quiet performance mode, the game is unplayable since the GPU isn't getting enough power. So we'll skip that setup. Instead, we'll focus on the optimized and turbo performance profiles with CPU boost on versus off. The difference is clear. While the CPU clock stays at base frequency, performance stability has much improved with boost off. Even GPU core, VRAM, and GPU hotspot temperatures has been reduced by around 8 degrees, along with a similar reduction in CPU temperature with lower power consumption. Avoiding that much of heat will increase components' longevity and avoid unnecessary generated heat. And here is the best part. Our FPS is actually better, with improved averages and lows on both optimized and turbo profiles. In terms of scores, we've got over a 300-point increase on optimized and around 75 on turbo. While it's not a huge gain, we are still running at much lower temperatures and power consumption, which is all we can ask for. So that's it, just want to change down for better efficiency, lower thermals, and more consistent performance on your Galaxy Book 4 Ultra. That will last you until you reinstall Windows. Keep in mind that this technique would work on other laptops as well, not exclusively just Samsung Galaxy Books. And I believe it's going to be worth sitting on like the Galaxy Book 4 Pro 360. I tried that one and found it suffered from similar issues even if it has fewer cores. Like even in simple desktop tasks, it was unresponsive at times and often showed thermal throttling with high temperature and power usage. Running anything on it will spike the surface temperature almost instantly and keeps fan loud. So this method will definitely help in such scenarios. If you are dealing with overheating and want to reduce temperature and power usage, disabling CPU boost is a good option. I hope this was useful. If it was the case, please give this video a like and subscribe to the channel. I'm also planning a Galaxy Book 4 Ultra GPU overclocking guide that promise higher GPU core clock and memory increase for some free performance gains. Finally, if you are facing issues disabling CPU boost or even have other problems with your notebook, let me know in the comments below or join us on the TechOSOR Discord server. Thanks for watching and see you guys in the next one.